I feel like the loss of grizzly bear is a symptom of a much larger problem.
It's not just loss of grizzly bear, it's loss of our own lake cultural autonomy. It's loss of connection to our land. It's loss of connection to our ceremony. Loss of kelp, there's loss of otter, there's loss of abalone, there's all these things that are just gone. It's just a loss of so much.
If the goal is to have grizzly bears come back, then we need to start at the very bottom and work our way up. We need to work on setting the foundation so that way we have the welcome mat open for them and they're ready to come in. It means restoring a lot of acres of land. It means preserving acres of land that want to be developed so that way there's pathways for these bears to come back. It's creating these welcome mats that are not necessarily made for humans. It depends on us. It depends on humans. It would seem like no human involvement in a way for like the grizzly bears to come back, but really the humans have been there the whole time making ready for these bears to come back. As tribes, we are very willing and, you know, very available to mix our old traditions with our modern solutions.
Native people are a keystone species. We are the ones who are able to steward these spaces well. We have generations of knowledge of these spaces and how we took care of them and how we stewarded them well. That's why I feel like it's so fruitful to be here on the land, this first instance of land back, because it is our own cultural autonomy. It's the start of it coming back. It's the start of these new things like, okay, this was a wrong that was done, but now here we are taking the steps forward to revitalize it, to give it back.
To give us land back so that way we can work on it and figure it out, that is, in my opinion, critical to not only bringing the grizzly bears back, but also, in my opinion, towards a better climate.